Hello Libra, welcome to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. Thank you for all your likes, shares and subscribes. This is going to be a September spirit message, so hopefully you'll like, share and subscribe once you've heard this. There's other messages on my channel if you want to look at them. But Spirit, please show me today the message you want me to give Libra, please. Oh, beautiful. Love it. Six, success. This is a six card. Milk and honey. All the blessings there are there for you. There's success at the end of this rainbow. Pot of gold at the end of the rainbow here, Libra. Remaining positive is always important. When we're in this positive energy, we attract more positive things to our life. It's a law of attraction, isn't it? So beautiful. Oh, and it's a perfect time. So stay positive. It's a perfect time. You're on the right path towards your milk and honey. Your blessings are coming in. You're moving towards success here. Whatever it is you're doing or putting your efforts into here, Libra, is going to serve you well. Okay, these cards have all been shuffled prior. I've got my energies on them. I've had these ones for 30 years when my son was born. They were first cards I ever bought. The Fool card. Two of Pentacles. The Lover's card. Beautiful energies. The Knight of Pentacles, Page of Wands, which is your central card. Your Knight of Cups is your movement. The Six of Swords on your perfect timing, beautiful card. Justice card, and the beautiful Magician card. My goodness, I'm Libra. This is great. I'm excited. Right, on your milk and honey, this is about taking a leap of faith. So whatever it is that you're putting your efforts into, it's about trusting, believing, remaining positive and being forward, being prepared to jump forward and do whatever you need to do to go towards bringing in your blessings. Now, the Fool's a zero card. He's starting from nothing and he travels light. He doesn't bring with him all his troubles. You have heard that, pack up your troubles and your old kit back. We're not bringing it with us. We're leaving it behind here. We're leaving past people, events, environments, situations that have disappointed us. We're not taking any burdens with us. We're traveling light here. And that's the beauty of the Fool. It's brand new beginnings. He's starting at zero in that sense. And he's jumping off the cliff, prepared to take the risks you need to take, ready to move forward to bring balance into your life. Now, this can be weighing things up about what you want to let go, what you're going to keep. It's about calming the waters. The waters there are behind him. You're calming things, you're balancing things out here, which puts you in a great position to make good, solid judgments. Now, this can be in your finances, your work life, your home life, or your relationships, anything that's tangible in your life. So weighing things up, you could be making a head over heels decision and you're going to say, right, I'm ready to take the risk and jump forward towards what it is I want for myself. Now, we've got here the Lover's card, which can be a decision-making card. It's Gemini. The old idea of this card was choice. So making that choice to weigh things up, decide what needs to come and what needs to go possibly, and move towards this, taking this leap of faith to go towards your success here. Now, this could also be making a decision to go into a relationship with someone, obviously. You know, so weighing things up, you might have two draws. How am I going to fit this relationship in? If I've been single, I might have to weigh that up. You know, I might have to have a wee bit financial plan because I might want a wee bit money to go out and date this person, have nice times, anything like that, anything like that. But it's about, this could also, like I say, about taking up a relationship with someone and having to balance out your life in general to make room for them if you've been single. Now, remaining positive, this is about going towards taking that leap of faith over something that we're passionate about. So like I say, it could be a person that you're passionate about. You might have someone that you've got your eye on, or somebody's got their eye on you, and you're both aware of this. How am I going to go forward? I'm going to stay positive. I'm going to believe that I am I'm allowed to have, you know, everything that's good and have good people around me. Now, this could also be weighing things up about taking on a course. It could be going towards a new job, taking a leap of faith and bringing about this change in any area of your life, studying a new skill. It could be starting up a sideline if you've got a craft that you're good at. You could be creative, whether it be arty, and you could be selling your paintings. You could be writing short stories, anything that you know that's going to make your heart sing, that you're passionate about. It's about the idea of it and staying positive in your abilities to achieve, because we've got two cards of movement here. And when we're in a positive energy, you will get movement. Now, knights are about going forward. This could be the opportunity of the relationship coming forward. It's from a very caring person. This could also be an apology from someone that puts your relationship back on an even keel. But if this is a person coming in, it's Cancer, Pisces or Scorpio. Now, it could be someone coming in with a loving opportunity. It doesn't have to be romantic. It could be a new friendship that comes forward that works well for you. All that type of thing. It could be an opportunity that you're passionate about. Like I say, somebody acknowledging you that you've got a skill and they're prepared to invest in it. And it's a loving, caring energy. It's a genuine opportunity that's being presented. So if you, for example, are arty, or you're writing music, or you're writing stories, or wanting on a course, this is the opportunity of moving towards that. You're going to move towards that. Now, this is the slowest knight in the pack. He's a knight of pentacles. And the reason he's slow is because he's very deliberate in everything he does. So, for example, it might be that you've had to wait to start a new job. It might be you've had to wait to get on your course. It might be you've had to wait on work for something that you're passionate about. It might be you've waited a long time on a relationship coming in. But the beauty of this knight is that he's got everything he needs to go forward. So he's done his homework. He's well-versed. If you're good at what you do, you're laying a solid foundation, for example, on anything you want to create. There's going to be movement and success. So making sure, for example, you've filled in all your bursary forms before your bursary comes through. Details. It could be contracts, any kind of details. If you're setting up something for yourself, it might have taken you time to establish yourself, or it might have taken you time to decide how you want to go forward and what you want to create here. But there's beautiful stability coming forward. You might have to learn some more information before you could start something up. And it's about remaining positive. So he's dotted his I's, he's stroked his T's. And if there's contracts or anything to be signed, be looking at the small print here, because it's very solid foundations that you're creating here for your future through remaining positive, doing what you're passionate about, and it's going to move you towards your happiness here, definitely. Now, it's the perfect time to be manifesting. And part of manifesting is remaining positive. And manifesting is going towards your milk and honey. That's what manifesting is about. It's about having goals that are going to make you, that you're passionate about, that you can create, that you're going to enjoy doing, going into relationships you're going to enjoy being in, and environments that you're going to enjoy being in. And this is what manifestation is. And what Spirit's saying is you're in a beautiful position now, Libra, to bring forward anything or to start anything that you choose for yourself that you want to do here. So it's taking the leap of faith now. Everything is right. The time's right. It's perfect timing to take that leap of faith to go forward towards what it is that you want for yourself here. Now, when you do that, you're going to move towards success. And the sixes are success cards. They're movement as well. You're going to start to see clearly what it is that it's a perfect time for you to go forward towards what it is you want for yourself. Like I say, now this is Spirit in the boat and he's guiding you. Spirit guides you out of choppy waters. So like I say, anything, weighing things up, smoothing out the waters in the background here, starting to work out how you're going to go forward. So like I say, if it's a relationship, you might have to weigh things up and how you're going to fit someone in. If it's a night course or something new you're learning, you might have to think about how you're going to go forward now. But it's definitely the time to be thinking about your manifestations and your goals, because you're going to go towards success. And what Spirit's saying here is that things are going to go in your favour. There's going to be fairness and karmic justice here. So if there's been any legal situation, for example, it's going to go in your favour. It's time. There's going to be a judgment. It's going to be fair and just for you. Now, judgments that are made are fair and just for everybody involved. So it might be a legal situation that comes to an end that is enabling you to manifest now and go towards what it is you want for yourself. It could be you're divorced and you're ready to start up a new relationship with someone, or you've got a legal settlement of some description with someone from your past and you can start new now. And you can go towards what it is you want. Now, it doesn't have to be in that sense. It could be your contract, you've worked your notice now, and you're ready to go forward. It's the perfect time. For spirit is behind you here. It's karmic justice. You are always rewarded for being positive and manifesting. It can take a wee while to come in, but if you're positive and you remain, you're prepared to do whatever you want, the universe will help you to go forward towards your success here. Okay, Libra, now I'm just going to clarify. I'm not sure what to clarify, actually. I'm going to clarify the Justice card. Yeah. The universe is saying that this is perfect time for you to gain clarity about how you want to go forward. Now, I did say it could be a legal situation, so this could be a professional person. It could be a lawyer, for example. That brings in a legal settlement there, like I say, or the end of a contract or some description that's going to help you come forward, move forward. So if this is a person, it could be Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. It could be somebody communicating something to you, like I say, that's going to give you the clarity you need, the fairness you need to move forward. Or it could be you gaining the clarity through remaining positive and manifesting whatever it is you want and this and spirit and you know, helping you go forward. And this is about passion. It's things you're creating that you're passionate about. Now, when you're in this beautiful Queen of Wands energy, she knows exactly what she wants to create. She's very focused. She's very attractive. So if this is a relationship, like I say, somebody could be finding you very attractive or you could be finding somebody else very attractive. But if you've got a creative idea that you're good at, it's now time to take action and put it into practice and create something for yourself out of that, because that is going to bring you great happiness and joy for the future. This is the most auspicious card in the deck, and it's about sunshine and happiness and joy in every area of your life. So it could be, like I say, a judgment in your favour or just the universe. It's your time now. It's perfect time, Libra, for you to be successful in your goals. I'll just take these. Passion. Passion isn't confined to sexual energy. Life is meant to be felt. Don't hold back. Anything you're wanting to create now, it's definitely your time, Libra. Holiday. It's time to go on that holiday that you have been dreaming about. Live life. Okay? That would be wonderful. So I hope that helps, Libra. Please like, share and subscribe. And I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.